I know that everyone here will soon be marching over to the Capitol building to peacefully and patriotically make your voices heard. Today, we will see whether Republicans stand strong for integrity of our elections.
We need to go into the Capitol. Into the Capitol.
What?
No!
No!
Peaceful!
Fed! 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 Fed!
The announcement of the state of the vote by the President of the Senate shall be deemed a sufficient declaration of the persons elected President and Vice President of the United States, each for the term beginning on the 20th day of January, 2021.
I know your pain. I know you're hurt. We had an election that was stolen from us. It was a landslide election, and everyone knows it, especially the other side. But you have to go home now. We have to have peace. We have to have law and order. We have to respect our great peace.
Tonight, 2,000 National Guard troops are securing the Capitol, inside the grand halls and outside along the perimeter, some armed and authorized to defend themselves, a striking image reminiscent of the Civil War.
A rare and truly stunning sight, National Guard members sleeping on the marble floors of the Capitol overnight, stationed there to protect the building against any threat.
It is a solemn and grim day here in the nation's capital, where it feels like an occupying force has taken control.
20,000 troops in D.C. Now, this is a little bit less of a staged event and more of an event that we were told one thing, when in reality something else happened. And this is something I've been screaming about from the day it happened. If you go back and you follow the narrative, what was going on, and I realize a lot of people probably missed this just with all the chaos that went on with January 6th and everything that was going on in January of 2021. But to recap, if you recall what the actual narrative was in the wake of the January 6th insurrection, I say that in air quotes, that Nancy Pelosi and Mayor Bowser, the mayor of Washington, D.C., that they unilaterally called in 20,000 troops, National Guard troops, from all 50 states to secure the Capitol. They don't have that power. They never have. They never will. Yes, Washington, D.C. itself has a National Guard platoon. And yes, Mayor Bowser is considered the commander-in-chief of that particular platoon in Washington, D.C. But that's not what happened that day. In that day, 20,000 troops, and you can look this up yourself, representing all 50 states, descended on D.C. There is only one man that could have done that, because federalization of National Guard troops across state borders can only be done during war or a national emergency. And at that point, they are brought in as part of the United States Marines. And the only person that can bring 20,000 troops into occupy DC is the President of the United States, which at this point was Donald J. Trump. So I'm here to tell you, for anybody new that hasn't been following this stuff, what you watched, what you witnessed in January of 2021 was the White Hat military occupying, securing, and taking over Washington, D.C. You watched a legal military coup of the fraudulent United States government. And it happened right on your own news channels. They just told you a different story. These are incredible times we are living in. And I think what I'm about to finish up with this last little montage of videos, when the history books are written and when the public finally knows and accepts what actually happened, their heads are going to spin. And quite honestly, guys, when I watch this to this day, even though I know what happened, my head spins to think that I actually watched 20,000 troops occupy the capital of the United States, erect barbed wire fencing, and take over a city. It's the things that we watched in high school, right? It's the things that we watched about Berlin in World War II, or different cities that were taken over and occupied by military forces. Well, that's what we watched on our own soil. They just told us a different story. But if you were paying attention, they gave us lots of clues. And you'll see in the beginning of this clip, the first one, which is the most obvious, is when on Good Morning America, you were told that the troops were coming in for a peaceful transition to military power.
Allow me to say how proud I am of the almost 25,000 National Guardsmen who have come in from all 50 states and territories to help support the Secret Service and the police departments with a peaceful transition of military power.
Before it's all over, and we got a long road ahead of us, I don't think you can actually clean up Washington, D.C. I don't think you can fix it. It's already fixed. President Trump's going to have to invite all of his contractor buddies. They're going to have to put a fence around D.C. three layers deep. You're going to have to pamphlet the city. Anybody that wants out, we got metal detectors, and you're going to get strip searched. You're not getting out with any of the evidence. Anybody that wants to stay, you're an enemy combatant. We're going to flood the city and wash it out. We're going to divert the Potomac. We're going to watch where the water comes out of those slimy holes. I don't care if they're 200 miles away. And then, after we flushed it clean about three times, because we're not taking any chances with any of our guys, then we're going in, we're going door to door, and we're going to clean that place out, and we're not going to occupy it again. We're just going to leave it fenced up as a spectacle to the world of the insanity of these groups that have tried to manipulate us. And we're going back to right thinking, godly thinking, sound thinking.
7 p.m. here on Sunday in Washington, D.C., and it sucks here. Okay, what do you hear? You hear it? There's no one even here. It's crazy. It's awful here. That's what it looks like in Washington, D.C. Today is Sunday, February 7th, 2022. It's around 7 p.m. It's dead.
I hope you guys take a real close look at those images, because to me, they're burned in my head at this point. The troops surrounding the Capitol with automatic weapons, the barricades, the razor wire. And remind yourself that this was still during the tail end of the COVID hysteria, and the fact that they didn't allow anybody into D.C. for the inauguration. So do you see how the logic of putting 20,000 troops in there doesn't make any sense? There wasn't anyone coming to begin with. you could have simply roadblocked three or four highways in and out of the city and accomplished the same thing. Why were there 20,000 troops? And then why were they there not for the inauguration for a week? They were there for over 2 months. What were they doing for 2 months? Why was the razor wire facing in? Go back and look. The razor wire was facing into the Capitol building so that people couldn't escape. Go look at those images again and just really think about what you were told and then what you saw with your own eyes. And you saw in that video I showed you that that gentleman was that was on Good Morning America told you right there that there were 20,000 troops from all 50 states. That can only happen if the National Guard is federalized by the Commander-in-Chief of the United States, which at that point was Donald J. Trump. Nothing you were told about that period of history was true. What you saw with your own eyes and what we're telling you now, that's the truth. And I encourage everybody to go back and really take a look at what went on. And then, you know, beyond that, and maybe we'll do another one of these, Richard Citizen journalist, Nancy Drew, people have been documenting for the last 3 years how DC, you saw at the tail end of that clip, RCJ talking about how deserted DC was. There's been people documenting that for 3 years now, that there are the Federal Reserve building is virtually abandoned. The FBI building is virtually abandoned. We have video that we've shown here on the channel on Telegram of explosions happening and detonations happening inside the FBI building at 1 o'clock in the morning. The HUD building is empty. The Department of Education building is empty. You go by these buildings at 4 or 5 in the afternoon during rush hour, and there's three people standing outside having cigarettes. The subway stations are empty. Sure, if you went there and maybe you weren't really paying attention and looking, there's people walking around, the city's functioning. But none of these buildings have been what they were pre-2021 for the last 3 years. And we have so much documentation of that.